Hello and welcome to another Java and Android Studio tutorial. My name's Cal and in today's video we're going to be creating a simple number picker. In the first half of the video we're going to use a number picker and populate it with some numbers, sort of the most basic and simple way, should only take a couple of minutes. And then in the second half of the video we're going to populate our number picker but with some text. In this example I'm going to use languages. Yeah, number pickers, they're super useful, great way to get user input from the user if you've only got a short list of things that you want to select from. And yeah, it's a really easy way, really easy component to implement.
Cool, so just starting today's tutorial, I'm just going to create a new Android Studio project, empty activity, and I'm going to call this number picker tutorial. Cool, and with our layout, I'm just going to keep using the constraint layout. I'm just going to move the text view up a little bit and change constraint vertical bias to 0.1. And I'm just calling the text number picker example, and I'm going to give it an ID, text view number picker, and just making the text size a little bit bigger and black. Next, down below, I'm going to add in our number picker, going to give it an ID, so calling it number picker. And I'm just going to drag that below our text view, and then I'm going to add in this constraint top to bottom of, and then give it our text view. And then next, we're just going to copy and paste the constraint left of and right of equal to parent from our text view and put that into our number picker. Cool, so that was our very simple number picker layout all finished. Next, what I'm going to do is head into the main activity. I'm just going to declare both the text view and the number picker. So just calling private text view and calling it text view, and private number picker and calling it number picker. And then I'm just going to find both of those components by their ID. So just casting text view to text view, and I'm going to cast the number picker to number picker, and then find view by ID. And then it's those IDs we gave earlier. So text view number picker and number picker. And I'll just give a quick example of how you can use number pickers with numbers. So just calling number picker dot set max value to 10 and set min value to 0, so you can select anywhere between 0 and 10 as your range. And then I'm going to say number picker dot set value, which is 5, so the initial value that it is. So it's going to, when it first loads, it's going to be at 5. And then I'm going to say number picker dot set on value change listener, and then I'm going to say new on value change listener, hit enter, and we'll get that override method. And then in our on value change method, I'm actually just going to change these ints. So the first one's actually old value and the second one is new value. And then I'm just going to call textView.setText, and then I'm going to say selected plus a little bit of space and new value. And if we build and run this, you can see how easy it is to populate a number picker with some basic numbers. Number pickers are a great way to get input from the user without needing to do any other validation. We can also use number pickers to display text, have the user select from some predetermined values. So in this example, I'm going to use languages. I'm going to have it so you can select from languages. So I'm just going to create a new Java class. I'm going to call this language. Making our language class public, we're going to have an int ID and a string name as our two fields. Just want to right click and say generate constructor, and then highlight both fields and hit OK. And then we're going to do the same thing. So right click, generate, and this time getter and setter for both fields. Next, what we're going to do is declare a static array list. So just something to hold all of our languages in. So I'm just calling this language array list. And then we want to create a static method called initLanguages. We just want to create all of our language objects. So the first one is English, new language, and then giving an ID of 0 and the name is English. And then I'm just going to add that into our language array list, and then do the same thing for French and Japanese, and just changing the IDs and the names. Cool. So we also need a getter for our language array list. So I'm just going to right click and generate. And then we're going to create one more method. This is again a static method, and it's going to return all of our language names in a string array. And so I'm just going to create a new string array, call it names, and then say new string array of the same size as our language array list. Using a for loop, we're just going to leap through our language array list and add each one of the names to our names array and simply just return that names array. Cool, so we can head back into the main activity now, and we're going to get rid of this set value at the bottom here. And we're just going to say language init languages, and then we're going to say set max value to language.getArrayList.size -1, set displayed values to language.languageNames, and then in our text views.setText we're going to say language.getLanguageArrayList.getNewValue.getName. So basically what we're saying here is get our language name based on the position of the number picker. Cool, and just a little bit of tidying up. Back in our language I forgot to initialize our ArrayList, so I'm just saying LanguageArrayList is equal to new ArrayList, and then I'm actually going to make the number picker layout width a little bit wider just so it looks a little nicer. But yeah, if we build our app again, you can see that when you scroll through you select any of our languages and it puts it into our selected. So in summary, we've learned how to use a number picker and populate our number picker with numbers, and we've also been able to populate our number picker with some text. Consider subscribing if you'd like to see more Android Studio and app development tutorials, but otherwise I'll catch you guys in the next one.